Hello all, my name is Ankit. I'm gonna start advanced Python series. So what we'll be discussing in this entire series, let me provide a very basic overview of this series. So first we will talk about a class, then we'll talk about some other topics like inheritance, polymorphism, static methods, dunder methods and many more. I'll cover each and everything related to OOPs in Python. So first we'll talk about what is a class and how to write a class in this particular video. So guys, if you don't know what is the OOPs concept, so please go and watch my videos because I have already created on my YouTube channel, so you can visit. Okay, so with the help of class keyword, we can create any class in Python. You can see here. So this piece of code just similar to some other object-oriented programming language. Okay, for example, just imagine I just write the code for Java. Okay, like class mobile. Okay, in Java, how to create a class in Java? Like this, and in Python like this. So both are similar. Okay, so we can understand easily what is the difference between Python class and Java class. So here I'm using curly braces, here I'm using pass keyword. Okay, so I'm going to write whole the code, then I'll be discussing one by one each and everything related to a class in Python. Now I have written very basic code, you can see here, and first we will understand what is the init method, guys. And also I have written one small piece of code for Java language. You can see this is a class for Java. Okay, so we can easily compare, you know, Python class with Java class, right? So here, what is the init method, guys? So init method just equal to the constructor. So guys, you can see in Java, constructor name same as class name, but in Python these kind of terminologies not exist. Actually we can use init method, which is, you know, you can see here double underscore and init, and after that double underscore. And another important thing, guys, here every method inside the class in Python takes one parameter, which is the self parameter by default, which is advisable. So it is recommended for every methods inside the class in Python, guys. Why it takes, I'll talk in later videos, so always remember, guys. So guys, here you can compare this thing. Here I'm using name, so actually you can say this is a keyword, or this is not a user defined parameter. These are user defined parameter, name and price only. So with the help of self, we can represent the properties, or you can say fields. Okay, so these are the instance variables, or these are the parameters. Okay, right. So this is an important thing. So now we will move on how to create an object in Python, guys. It's pretty simple with the help of this line. Okay, we can just write here your mob equal to mobile. Okay, with the help of this line we can create an object of a class, guys. So it's pretty simple, but the problem is that when we press shift plus enter, we will get an error, because guys, so inside this only parameterized init method available. It is just similar to Java class. When we create any constructor inside the Java class, so default constructor is never created. So in Python also, these kind of approach or these kind of scenario available. When we create any init method inside the class, so default, you can say non-parameterized init method is not created. Okay, so we need to pass some arguments. So we need to pass arguments like name, for example, Python, or some mobile name we can pass. For example, Sam, Asus. Okay. Asus, as, and price something like 15k. okay, then it will run. Okay, fine, you can see, and also we can see the properties for, so you can see here, and also we can call this specification method. So we can copy and your mob, put it. And one thing always remember, we can't pass argument for self parameter forcefully. So if I'm trying to pass something like that, so again we will get an error. Okay, so we can't pass forcefully. Okay, so you can see here. Okay, we can provide some space. So for example, what happen. Okay, we need to refresh that, so I'm just ignoring. Okay, so guys, with the help of class we can represent any kind of objects which has similar kind of properties and behaviors, so we can easily able to represent any objects in programming world. So if you like it, then give us thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.